Right. Here we are. There's my men up ahead.
Hello.
Whoa. We chase killer now. Kola with Yumpi. Hilpo. Bunyapi Ktelo. This way. Colonel Favors, Captain Munro, we come in peace.
Hello again. Who are these two?
They're friends of my people.
Interesting looking fellows.
Yeah, they won't cause any trouble.
Well, I should hope not. Listen, Mr.
Chief.
Yes, Mr. I can't say that silly name. What is it?
In English, they call me Rainsfall.
Yes, yes, I'm sure they do. Listen, we're all Americans here, and we want an outcome. But quite frankly, I'm confused. Your men are little more than criminals, in my opinion. Keep breaking peace treaties we've made, causing disturbances in everybody's lives. But I pride myself on being a gentleman. Really, I do. But there are limits. So, let me be very... Are you okay, man? Someone. Jackson, take him away. Where was I?
You're a gentleman with limits?
Are you being facetious, sir?
Come this way, buddy.
I said... Are you being facetious, Captain Munro?
No, sir, I am not.
Chief Rains.
That's, Rains' fault.
Exactly. Chief Rains, the thing
is... quite a cough. The federal government...
Sure.
Wait here. I'll fetch you some water.
I'll be fine. Thank you.
No, no. You know he's going to have Munro court-martialed. Or attempt to... He's going to make a disgrace of him.
Munro? Seems likable enough for a West Pointer. Why?
You know what Favors is like. Because he thinks it's right. Because he thinks Munro is a patsy. Or a spy. He's convinced he had something to do with those vaccines getting stolen. He thinks Munro is going to force him into making a concession with the Indians. So he removes Munro.
Removes how?
Favors wants him tried for treason. And hanged.
Why does Favors care about the Indians?
Because he doesn't want to back down. His whole professional life. You know what they say about him. Hightail Favors. The man who missed a battle.
Poor Munro. Kind of liked him.
I know. Well, still, he's kind of stuck up.
Your men violated the treaty. That treaty is null and void. I have been appointed to negotiate.
Feeling better?
Yeah. Come on. Let's go.
The lands you currently occupy belong to the United States government. Why is this so confusing, sir? Why?
Good day, Colonel Favors.
Well, that was remarkably unproductive.
So?
I'm afraid the federal government was quite clear, Colonel, that it wanted peace, and peace for all, and that the treaty had not been broken by anybody.
Oh, is that so, sir? And did it want impudence, sir, from a junior officer in public? Was that its plan too, sir? You insult me. You insult the regiment. Arrest this man.
Arrest me?
Gross insubordination. Disobeying an order. Treason.
Are you mad?
You had those vaccines stolen. You disrupted a negotiation.
Let him go.
This is all getting out of hand.
Hi,
Captain Monroe. Let's get out of here.
If I
were you, I'd keep my mouth shut, amigo. I don't want to kill this man, but shout.
Get off me.
Charles, Captain Monroe, mount up now. We're getting out of here.
I'll kill you. You won't get away. This way.
We got some on our tail.
I can't shoot at these men.
Yeah, but we can.
Look out! He's still coming. Do now.
You get out of here. Fast. Take you to the station.
I can't believe that just happened. I've been an army man my whole life.
I heard them talking. They was gonna have you hang for treason. You can't die for those fools.
And what about the chief?
We'll do what we can.
Guess I won't be submitting my report.
I wouldn't think so. Here, Captain Monroe.
I fear it may be Mr. Monroe from now on.
I'm sorry about your career. Here. Here's some money. you take it and get out of here and start a new life somewhere. I hear Tahiti's nice.
Thank you.
Just hop on a train to San Denis, jump on a boat, but avoid Guam.
Where?
Forget about it.
Meet you back at camp.
Mr. Morgan! Are you okay?
Yeah. Never better. What are you doing here?
Well, I'm on my way down to Mexico. They're finally sending me on a mission. Brother Dorkins is very jealous. What's wrong?
I'm dying, sister.
Okay.
Yeah, I got TB. I got it. Beating a man to death for a few bucks. I've lived a bad life, sister.
We've all lived bad lives, Mr. Morgan. We all sin. But I know you.
You don't know me.
Forgive me, but that's the problem. You don't know you.
What do you mean?
I don't know, but whenever we happen to meet, you're always helping people and smiling.
I had a son. He passed away. I had a girl who loved me. I threw that away. My mama died when I was a kid. And my daddy, well, I watched him die. And it weren't soon enough.
My husband died a long time ago. Life is full of pain. But there is also love and beauty.
What am I gonna do now?
Be grateful that for the first time, you see your life clearly.
Sure.
Perhaps you could help somebody. Helping makes you really happy.
But I still don't believe in nothing.
Often, neither do I. But then I meet someone like you. And everything makes sense.
You're too smart for me, sister. I guess I'm afraid.
There is nothing to be afraid of, Mr. Morgan. Take a gamble that love exists and do a loving act.
All aboard!
I shall try.
I know you will. Goodbye, goodbye, Mr. Morgan. Goodbye.
Sister. Yep.
Hamish.
Arthur! Come in.
You said, we could go for a hunt.
I did. There's this huge she-wolf been stalking me the last few nights I've been out, but she can wait. Let's talk a while.
Sure.
So what do you do?
Me? I'm a wanderer. I was born further north, but I spent a lot of time out west. It's funny, I never saw myself as a wanderer.
bodies lay so thick, they could have walked across the whole field without your boots touching mud.
Those were bad times. Mm.
Yes, they were. Would you like some more coffee?
Please.
Ooh-wee!
What have we here?
Yeah, she's right across there.
That close.
Oh, she's acting brazen. Come on, let's mount up.
Come on, she went around to the left, around the lake. She's down here somewhere. You with me? Come on. Hey!
Wolf shouldn't come so close to people.
Yeah, it's strange. When the whole country was wild, they could go where they liked. Now they're stuck hiding in the few corners of wilderness we got left.
It's a feeling with which I can sympathize.
This ain't a country for wild animals, nor wild men, neither.
Not anymore, it seems.
You hear that?
Yep.
Quickly now, this way. Up there, on the outcrop, you see her? Let's go around it.
Okay, I'm with you.
We're on to her. Come on.
Okay.
Damn! I can't see her. Let's get up to the top. Have a look around from up there. View loves hills, don't you, boy? You eat them up for breakfast. Easy. What we got here? Is that a fresh kill?
Could be. Is the blood set?
Let me take a look.
Yep. That was her dinner. Now, where'd she get to?
Guess. She's gone somewhere over there.
Well, there's a whole lot of over there.
That's the problem.
There she is. Got shy all of a sudden. You got some extra miles in you tonight.
Oh, if we got a chance. Let's chase her.
All right. Come on.
Hey, boy. Get in.
Through the scrub. Better to be on. Send your horse somewhere safe.
Get going, boy. There's a wolf about.
You went in there, all right. We got a tracker. Now you want to take the lead, or shall I?
If you don't mind, I'd like to.
Okay, get tracking. I'll be close behind you.
I got the trail. This way.
Right behind you. Make it slow. You see anything yet?
Just tracks.
We heading down here?
We don't get her. Well, what's the worst that can happen? She runs off with the chicken?
Well, I'm fine with losing chickens. I lost a leg already. I gotta pull down my pants to shit me. Oh, man. Gosh, no. There's more of them. We walked in. into something here.
Whoa.
You all right?
I was ready to offer my complete and unconditional.
Yeah, I don't think the wolves would have shown much mercy.
That's quite an ambush he led us into.
Yeah, bushwhacking, I'd call it.
Huh? Goddamn! Over here! Over here!
Whoa,
you all right?
I was ready to offer my complete and unconditional.
Yeah, I don't think.
Damn you, monster!
Arthur! Shit!
Whoa,
you all right?
Damn you, monster!
Arthur! Shit!
You all right?
Yeah.
Damn. Big son of a bitch.
Is that all of them?
That's the best of them. Look at them. Proud thing.
Scary thing. They brought us here to be slaughtered.
You were after a hunt.
Yeah. Yeah, and I guess I got hunted. You going back to the cabin?
Nah. Still early. We'll stay up here a while. Dress this animal. Won't likely see another like him for some time.
Yeah, I hope I won't either. Thanks for taking me out.
Yeah, anytime. You want to go out again? You come by and see me.
So long, then.
Wait. Here's a pelt.
Thank you.
You earned it. So long. He could speak stories he'd tell.
Thank you.
Yep.
You trying to rob a sick man?
I was trying to help.
Bullshit, you was.
I hope you move, fancy boots. Unlike you, I'm honorable.
Let's go, boy. Yep. Okay there, boy. Go.
Settle in, friend. We're a long ways off still. One piece.
Thanks for the ride, partner.
It's you.
I got his letter.
Mr. Arthur.
Sir?
Education is the most wonderful thing. It'll raise us higher and higher. Make civics and ethics less a work of a dirty-minded pragmatist like me, and the calling of higher, better men.
Hear, hear.
Without it, we are savages. But with learning, why, in 50 years, man will put down his guns and start living a life of relentless purity.
Hear, hear.
But the rich can be so very self-absorbed.
How can I help?
You can't.
We need all our strengths. That's the point. We've gone over this.
Violence is never right.
I agree with you. But it's not violence. It's the mere threat of violence.
Against whom?
Oh. Against Hector Fellow's worst nature. To convince him to make good on his promise to help finance the library.
Who is he and where do I find him?
He's a newspaper man. And he's...
He's leaving town on a coach, heading to his country estate because he doesn't like your heavy-handed approach.
Well... You certainly won't like my heavy-handed approach.
Thank you, Mr. Arthur.
You'll spot him on the road through the bayou. He has a red coach. So we are clear. I do not approve of this behavior.
Okay, boy.
coach!
Who the heck are you?
Just going to talk to your passenger a moment. When I get in, you carry on.
What the hell do you want?
Mr. Fellows, ain't it? Charity, sir. And an appeal to your better nature.
This is most impudent.
Oh, no, it's not most impudent. Trust me, buddy. I can get a whole lot more impudent. But this is a good cause for a wealthy man such as yourself. The chance to add some dignity to all that wealth.
Dignity?
By helping to finance a library in town. Think of the prestige, sir.
Oh, get out of my carriage.
But the mayor.
The mayor? The mayor is a crook.
Me too. And I'm a real crook.
I will not be bullied by you, sir. Get out of here.
Sorry, was that? Yes, I'd like to finance the library for the common good. I didn't hear you. What was that?
Please! All right!
There. You see? That wasn't difficult. You know, they say it's better to give than to receive. And certainly in the case of a beating, I know that's true. Now, the mayor awaits your check, sir. Been a pleasure. There's a good man in there. Let him live a little more. Driver! Hold up! As you were. Come on!
Just beyond belief.
Yeah.
bien le bonjour, monsieur. Hey, have a care, would you?
Apologies.
Welcome, sir. Come in and have a browse. When you're ready, have a browse of our catalog. And I can go out back and get what you're looking for. Looks like you've been taking good care of that gun. I've got some better stocks that would fit that gun. Can add to stability. I could fit some different stocks for you. Could make it more comfortable on the shoulder. I can do some nice ornate engraving on there. If you like, good price. And will you be needing any ammunition? Do you have enough ammunition for that thing?